So I think we're all good. Yes, we are recording. So my name is Anna. I am the founder of We Are Fit Attitude. And very kindly, I have Liz here, who has been a member with us since January 2019 and has said that she's happy to tell us her story and her journey with WAFA. So I've got a few questions to ask you, Liz. So you joined in January 2019, mm-hmm. But you, at that time, you had applied for my 6-week program, the Body Fix in Six. So can you just go back to that time and just give us a little bit of insight as to why you applied for the program? Where were you at in terms of Liz at that time?
It was quite funny, actually. I'd been to New Zealand for Christmas, and New Zealanders are not are pretty straightforward with things that they say. And my brother was quite rude about my size. He was like, "Oh, I see, we've got the bigger Liz back in New Zealand this year." And I'd actually had quite a tough year in 2018 because I've lived here for over 20 years now. Lots of friends have moved back. All my other friends decided to have children in their 40s. And when they first had them, it didn't really impact my life. But once they get to 5 or 6, they start going to school and then they start making friends with other parents and things. And I just actually found with some of my other friends, I just didn't have that much in common. Like, I'd had specific friends to go for walks with, and I'd lost all the ones who enjoyed doing the exercise. And I was really bored with my gym. I wasn't motivated enough to go, even though it's actually just down the end of my road and I have to walk 20 minutes to get to WAFA. And I realised I wanted to meet some more local women so that, you know, I could walk down the street and recognise faces and say hello, etc. And I saw the ad and I thought, oh my gosh, it's almost like that's exactly what I've been looking for. So, I was like, right, that's it. I'm joining.
Brilliant. So you joined in January, you did the first 6 weeks, you did Body Fix in Six. Do you remember the experience? I mean, what was your first impression when you joined WAFA?
I remember I was really nervous about going into a room full of women that I didn't know. But I was also really excited. I did start the same night as Natalie, who works for WAFA now, and she and I got on like a house on fire from the start. So that really helped. But I remember doing my first class and we had to do like deadlifts and I could only get the bag halfway up. And I was just like, and that was the light one, the 10 kilo one. And I was like, I'm never gonna be able to do this. And then the amount of squats that we did, and the next few days, not wanting to go to the toilet because I just didn't want to have to sit down. And, I remember walking around the office and making silly little noises every so often. And that's the other thing. I'm a contractor, so I work in different companies all the time. So it's great. For my mind and for the kind of work that I do, but it's not good for building long-term friendships because you're only there for a certain amount of time. So, but yeah, I wasn't the best at tracking my food or following the recipes or anything like that, because what I did it for was my headspace and for the physicality. I wanted to get leaner, stronger, but I also wanted to feel happy again. And in the dark of January, it was quite nice to know I had somewhere to go 3 times a week.
So we're in May now, of 2020. So you've been on quite a journey. You've been with us now for, well, almost a year and a half now. So what do you say is your biggest achievement that you've had at your time at WAFA?
I think it was the three peaks. That was one of the other reasons that I've stayed, is because of the challenges, and I love a challenge. And it was so funny, you know, I really, really love my sleep, and I'm not very good at getting up in the mornings. And I remember when we were training, we used to go for training walks at like about 6 o'clock. And we'd get up at 6 and meet at 6:15 or 6:30 and go to Box Hill and do a couple of rounds. And I just remembered thinking, oh my God, who is this person that's doing this? But I loved it. And I just used to get home at 11 o'clock or 12 o'clock and after maybe doing one or two circuits. And knowing I'd done all my exercise, I'd had lovely chats with people, and the walking almost felt a bit of a breeze, and it was when I got to the Three Peaks, because it was completely different, you know, having to walk up Ben Nevis for 3 hours or something, or was it an hour and a half or 3 hours that we walked up, just up. But you know, that was really exciting, and I've got quite a strong mind. When I put myself, you know, when I decide to do something, I don't need to have people around me or anything like that. So I often walked by myself because I knew my pace, and I knew that if I didn't want to be distracted by anything, because I was there to do it. I wasn't there just to have a good time.
And I guess there's that thing about, and we talk about this a lot at WAFA, that, you know, I do, one of the goals is that I want to try and get women to look beyond the scales, because I think we get so completely focused on our weight and our body issues. And actually, I think what this has demonstrated is that, you know, you have, you took on a challenge like the Three Peaks, and then recently we did the 12-hour online workout. And in a way, you're kind of, then you're looking more at your achievements beyond what you see on the scales.
Oh, definitely.
Do you agree with that?
I'm somebody who will always obsess about my weight. It always goes up and down. And but you know, I'm working from home and locked down in my kitchen. It's terrible. Food is just there for me. And you know, what I've done is I now have this one dress that I try on every week or every couple of weeks. And if I'm not fitting it, then I stop eating so much. And that's all I'm going to do, is measure myself on that, because, and I do jump on the scales, but I think I'm heavier because I'm carrying more muscle. I definitely, my body shape has changed. I've got lovely arms now, and, you know, I do think about the weight, but I also really think about the fact that I'm over 50. I need to keep fit and healthy for for physical reasons. You know, I don't want to get diabetes. My father had diabetes. He had heart disease. I'm really conscious of that. And, you know, and you don't have to be that overweight or anything like that to have a heart attack. And my husband had a heart attack a few years ago. And, you know, everyone was like, but he's not that old, he's not that fat. And I just thought, you know what, you just never know that much about your body. And so now, when I go to the doctor, because I used to smoke as well, and I gave that up about 2 years ago, and they say to me, do you smoke? And I'm like, what? Of course I don't smoke. And I've almost forgotten that I did. And, you know, they take my blood pressure, and they're just like, oh my God, it's just so, you know, it's in the really, really healthy region. I don't need any drugs apart from HRT. So, yeah.
But that's great. I mean, that is a perfect example of, I mean, I know that we're always joking about how we like to enjoy a glass of wine and things like that. But actually, you know, you do work out and you are committed to doing the WAFA classes. I mean, when I think about when you first started to where you are today, I mean, your physical strength has changed so much.
Oh, yeah, definitely. You know, trying to do one of those burpees on the ground the first time, I don't think I could push myself back up. And, you know, and sometimes I was really like, oh, I don't know if I want to try it in case I can't do it and people laugh. But, you know, everyone's so friendly and I feel so comfortable there. I'll try things now and they don't always go well. I remember I did a burpee just a week or two before WAFA closed down and I was not thinking about what I was doing. I'm very good at being distracted. And I went down so quickly that I actually smashed my head on the floor. And I looked up and people had heard it at the floor. But, you know, we just all laughed and, you know, I carried on. Don't think I went down quite so low the next time.
But that's amazing that you're doing burpees and you know, and actually the fact that you could just have a laugh about it. And obviously we're now online and I mean, obviously we don't know when we're going to be back in the church hall, but you find the online, that I find the online works really well, but...
I actually love the online. It's so much easier for me to do an early class. Like I got up and did Sally's Pilates yesterday at 6:15. Now I wouldn't make a 6:15 class. As I said, I'd have to get up and drive there and so on. Whereas I just plotted out, did the class and I actually went back to bed and had another sleep. And I really needed the Pilates because I'm still sore from that 11 hours. So I did 11 hours of the 12-hour challenge because I hate mornings and I decided if I started earlier than 8:30, I might not have done as well. So I know my limitations as well. I work with my head and I said, if you start at 8:30, you just see how you feel. And if you can keep going, you just keep going. So I did the 11 hours. And, you know, my friends aren't really into fitness like me. They do some, but they were just astounded, you know, just like, you did 11 hours of HIIT classes, you know. And it makes you feel good. But I
feel good.
Yeah, and I did, and I was buzzing for a couple of days, yeah, afterwards. And, you know, we raised such an amazing amount of money, and that's the other thing I like. I love the whole ethos of the group, that we raise money for charity, that we have chats and bubbles, so you get to know the women as well. It's not just about working out.
Yes, exactly. So I guess my you know, there are a lot of women out there that often see the ads that I run, but just a little bit nervous, I think, about applying. There's a little bit of, you know, not really sure what, and actually sometimes they're just not in a really good place. So what would you say to any woman who sees our ad and is thinking about, you know, that they want to give it a go, but they just haven't got that confidence?
6 weeks is nothing for committing to something. And if you're feeling like that, making a change is one of the best things you can ever do for yourself. And, you know, doing physical exercise, you get all those happy endorphins. You know, the fact that you get to be outside of your normal working day and the people that you see every day also helps. You know, you walk in and you'll quickly make some friends, you'll get to know faces. We all do it at our own pace. Some days I'll do it much harder than others. I just know to read my body and say, today I'm not actually feeling as good as I normally am, so I'm not going to overstress myself. But yeah, I just think it's definitely been one of the best things I've ever done.
And long may it last, as far as I'm concerned. We need people like you, Liz. Thank you, Liz. I really appreciate that. That was really helpful. And I hope that it inspires some other women to not be afraid, that to know that we are a very caring group of women who really do have the best interests of the women to be the best version of themselves. So I think you've proved that you've gone from your New Zealand holiday to where you are now, and what a different person you are. Yeah. In a very positive way as well.
Great. No, thank you, Emma. And that's you're the reason that it's so good.
Well, myself and the team, we always are a collective thing, right? I see, I'm only as good as my team and also the members that we have. So it's all one big WAFA love. Hang on a minute.